Guys. Guys.
Sorry about that. Oh, welcome back, guys.
Hi.
Hi, guys. Welcome back to the Phoenix Files. Today, we're going to be talking about our phones.
I'm your host, Chelsea.
And I'm Jack. It's nice to see you guys virtually, which is actually the topic of today's episode. Chelsea, I have a couple of questions for you. And you saw them already. But I want to see if you know the answer to these. What do you think the average young adult of the time that young adults are spending on their screens in North America a day?
I know if it's anything like my screen time, it's a little bit embarrassingly high. But I think on average, I would guess 6 to 7 hours a day.
Yeah, so that's pretty close.
Yeah?
So people between the ages of like 18 and 24 are spending between 8.5 hours and 8 hours and 45 minutes.
Even the half hours.
Yes.
That's how much you should be sleeping.
Yeah. And then 4.5 of those hours are spent on social media.
Ooh.
Yeah. But that average, if you live to 80 years old, how long do you think you spend on your phone?
Oh, I'm not going to do the mental math right now. But if it's about as much as you sleep, they say you sleep for like a third of your life. Mm. So like a third of your luck. 20, that's terrifying.
Yeah, that's 12 consecutive years.
I feel a little bit hypocritical making a video podcast right now and complaining about their screen time. This doesn't count. Screen time was okay.
This is education.
This is, yeah, exactly.
No. To keep going on that, this just to make everybody sad. How many times a day do you think you pick up your phone?
Oh, too much, too much. I'm always like in class, every 5 minutes I'm like checking the time. I'm like looking at other notifications. So I don't even know. It's probably over 100 times a day.
You think it's over 100 times?
I don't open it and like start looking at it, but that I at least like turn on the screen.
Yeah, so people lift up their phones around 60 times a day with an average
of... It's not actually 100 times a day. That would be bad.
With an average of 3 minutes in between.
3 minutes? Whoa.
Over 50% of those are within work hours, by the way. So you spend more time on your phone at work than you do outside of work.
Yeah, I get that. I'm definitely checking the time more in class.
Okay, this is also crazy. How do you measure engagement?
Like
you.
Like how to apps and like
you. When you say you're engaged
on
social media, what does that mean?
When I'm engaged on social media.
Just there?
Yeah. Like what do you mean by engaged? Like when am I?
Well, you know, they say it gets the more engagement. It's more engaged.
Oh,
what do you
mean? Well, I think they mean like all the likes and comments and like stream time that people are spending, right?
In reality.
Like, can't they measure it?
No, bro. It just literally means the amount of time that you spent in a platform divided by the amount of times that you went into that platform. So at the end of the day, it just means how long were you looking at your screen on that app?
Just how long you were seeing.
How long you were looking at it. That's all engagement means.
That feels so yucky.
Yeah.
I saw, you're not engaged at all. Homie, you're just staring at a screen.
Of all the Instagram followers that you have, how many do you know? How many could you name? And how many do you actually want to hang out with?
I don't know how many I have off the top of my head.
That's a lot.
Should I look? I don't know off the top of my head. I'm going to guess and say like 450.
She's popular. How many do you know?
Well, there's like my family, so that's probably about 10 to 20 people plus friends from here. So like another 20 to 30.
So you know how of them, hopefully?
Hopefully. Oh, that actually feels really yucky that I would not know the people that are following me. $4.99 with us. $4.99.
Follow Chelsea.
Follow me on Chelsea_Martin. Gain of 500 followers.
Knowing that and the fact that we interview all of the people on campus.
Mm-hmm.
Could you just reflect on how these numbers make you feel about your phone use right now?
Bad. Just bad. Yeah, a little bit. Especially the question about the Instagram followers and how many people I like know and care about. Because like now I just feel really yucky that there's strangers following me. So don't follow me. I should cut that out.
Yeah, no, that's really interesting because so much of... I know my worth was attached to my persona online, and I was spending vastly over 4 hours a day on social media.
Mm-hmm.
And I was very much picking up my phone more than 60 times a day.
Yeah, I feel like I definitely pick it up more than 60 times.
So when we went out and interviewed people, which, by the way, is coming up.
Stay tuned.
Right? It gave me hope for our generation and the things that we have to do together to overcome our collective phone addiction.
Yeah.
Because I'm looking out into here and everybody is on their computer. Mm-hmm. Nobody really can just even be here. So
calling out the team here.
I think that is really important. No, not just the team, like a whole just lot of community.
Yeah.
It is necessary. Like when I ran into you today, randomly, you were just staring at.
That was so embarrassing. On our way here, well, a couple of hours ago, I'm walking around campus on my phone and Jack just goes, screen time. It's like.
So we're going to show you some clips of people around campus in our community. We're going to get their feelings on what it means to be addicted to your phone, if it's really within our control and what we can do to get better at those behaviors.
Yeah.
Also, stay tuned for that.
Seems like a good time to cut to us on the ground.
Yeah, for sure.
Okay, hi. Thank you so much for agreeing to an interview. What was your name?
My name is Cameron.
Hi, I'm Arun Arora, and I'm a third-year engineering student here at UBCO.
My name is Noah Pazlowski.
I'm Megan.
I'm Anne.
Mm-hmm. I'm Jackson.
I'm Sarah.
And I'm Sydney.
Hi, I'm Tiana Kaleo, like the Disney princess, or the song bust down thaw, Tiana. It's me.
Please. I'm Gavin.
All right, Gavin, nice to meet you. So as you noticed, we were walking around asking students about their relationship with their phone.
Yeah.
And somebody pointed out something very interesting over at the table, is that you have a flip phone.
I do use a flip phone.
So if you don't mind disclosing, what is your screen time?
Well, the last I checked, which was like 30 seconds ago, was 12.
12 hours.
Okay, so my daily average is 4 hours and 18 minutes right now, which...
I think it would be around 5 hours, 30 minutes, maximum in a day. Sometimes it reaches around 6 hours during the weekends, but not on the weekdays at all.
How do you guys feel about your screen time?
I'm not sure, really.
No?
Good?
Good. You feel good about your screen time?
I mean, I could honestly lower it, because some days I'm not on it, but others I'm on for like 5 or 6 hours in a row, and I could definitely cut back.
And what's your app of choice?
Unfortunately, TikTok or Instagram.
TikTok, Instagram? How about you?
I'd say the same, or music.
All right, music is
yeah,
great.
Probably Instagram.
Okay. Mine.
I would say it would be social media for sure, but sometimes when I explore something new, for example, if I'm going into stocks or a different cryptocurrency, then I'll be using a different app most of the time. And yeah, but it depends on the day, it depends on my mood too. But I would say majority of the time it would be Instagram or social media apps for sure.
Definitely Instagram.
Yeah, Instagram.
Me too. Me too, honestly.
If you guys weren't on Instagram or TikTok, what else would you guys be doing?
Depending on the season, if it's summer, warm outside, I'd probably be mountain biking. Mm-hmm. And since it's entering winter season, snowboarding.
Okay, great. So you would like to spend more time in your
physically
body outside?
Active, yep. Yeah.
How about you?
I don't know.
You don't know? That's valid.
I'd probably want to look into my future more, academically wise, mm-hmm. read more.
Yeah.
I used to read a lot more when I was younger, and now I kind of feel almost guilty for not doing it.
I have no idea, because studying more would just lead to burnout at this point. Mm-hmm. Maybe like read a book or something.
Probably reading.
Reading?
Yeah.
Okay, reading is a common phenomenon.
I've definitely thought about getting a phone that doesn't have a screen, though. Like getting like a flip phone, mm-hmm. so that I don't have access to apps.
We just interviewed a guy with a flip phone.
No way!
It was crazy.
It's kind of... impossible, because the screen covers half,
yeah.
or the text and the, like the all the little buttons cover half the screen.
Yeah.
So I don't, you get half the stimulus.
So I don't doom scroll anymore. That's awesome. Yeah.
Yeah. I want to be him.
I'm seriously considering it now.
Right.
And just lastly, how would you rather spend your time if you weren't spending it on your phone?
Enjoying life. Aww. I think. Like, doing things with, like, people in my life or going outside. Like, I don't know, really, like, basic things we don't think about that much. But, like, just, like, enjoying the world around me that's not just, like, the shitty screen I'm looking at all the time.
Totally.
Yeah, that would be my thing.
Okay.
All right. Thank you for answering those questions. You guys are a part of a very large project that we're working on, so thank you very much.
Okay, back in the studio. And I think it's only fair if we also answer these questions. So... our screen times. Mine is so embarrassing compared to yours. And we got receipts. Mine is 7 hours and 40 minutes. Is that daily average per week? Yeah.
You're doing the week?
Yeah.
I am currently sitting at a very, very good 2.5 hours.
Yeah, that's insane. That makes me feel so much worse about Lime. Because mine is lower than it used to be.
Yeah, that I was going to say. This is an adjusted time. We're going to talk about the act, what more realistic times look like. Yeah. Of those absorbitant 7 hours, what app do you spend the most time on?
YouTube and Instagram. YouTube, I just always have playing in the background. Like, I get home from school and I throw a YouTube video on. I'm always listening to, like, the news and that type of stuff. And then a lot of the time I do listen to it to, like, fall asleep. So it just racks up the screen time for me. And then just doom scrolling on Instagram.
It's about YouTube. You can doom scroll on anywhere. You can doom scroll. Facebook has reels.
Yeah, YouTube has reels. YouTube has, like, little TikTok-y things now. It's terrible.
For me, it's YouTube. Of the screen time, how do you feel about it? How much do you feel like you're wasting your time versus actually working? So 7 hours, how much of that is productive versus unproductive?
Well, I don't think any of it's like super productive. I mean, like, obviously, like, doom scrolling on Instagram feels very, very unproductive. I do feel better about, like, YouTube. Because, like I said, I watch the news. I watch, like, things that actually interest me.
Yeah.
Documentaries, podcasts, most of the podcasts that I listen to, I watch on YouTube, not just on Spotify. So I definitely feel better about it mostly being YouTube. And then it also being that more like long form content, I feel like I'm not completely like rotting my brain cells away.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I think that it generally split 50-50 for me. Half of the time, I feel pretty good. Like when I'm on my phone and I'm working for the gallery and I'm making content for social media and I'm on my phone for that, I don't feel bad. But I don't know how to make the distinction of working on my phone. I don't know when it just turns to me being on my phone.
Yeah.
I have zero self-control over that, which kind of leads us to our last question that we were asking folks, which is, have you ever tried to cut down on your screen time?
Yes, all the time.
What do you do?
Back in my second year, I think it was, I tried to delete TikTok and then I caved in like a month later and re-downloaded it, which I was really mad at myself for. But then last year, around exams in like April, I was laying in bed like doom scrolling on TikTok and I'm like, I have 3 exams to set for. I can't be doing this. And just deleted it right then and there and haven't gone back. So
okay, good for you.
Proud about that.
So you just delete the app that's running your brain.
Well, yeah, except now it's kind of just switched to Instagram Reels, but I'm definitely on it less.
Yeah.
And I have like the hour long
limit.
Yeah. That just comes with your phone. But then there's a little thing that's like, ignore the limit. I'm like, I wish it didn't have that. Don't let me ignore the limit. But I also have this app called One Sec, I think it's called. And you can use it for any app that you hook it up to whichever app so that when you open it, it like takes up the screen and like makes you take a deep breath. And then it has like, do I want to open Instagram? So it just like makes you like pause and think. And it's also really annoying for when you just want to like, oh, I've got 2 seconds. Let me like scroll through Instagram. It like takes 30 seconds to open Instagram. So then by the time you're like, what's that like compulsion of I need to look at my phone is done. It's like, but I don't actually need to be on this. So it's, I like that app. It's pretty helpful, I think.
That sounds like a great app, actually.
What have you done to cut down?
To cut down, I've tried so many things.
Easy.
When I first started, what I would do is I would physically not bring my phone places.
Mm-hmm.
So if I was going on a date with my partner or if I was going to go do sports or whatever, I would just leave my phone at home. Or I'm an overworker. I work so much. It's just like, 'cause I'm a painter and I think that that's just part of being a painter. So I would just leave my phone at school and go home.
At school?
And
oh my God.
Not use it.
Yeah.
Because I'm more prone to use it in private moments. Like, I'm more prone to use my phone when I'm with my partner as opposed to just being with my partner. I'm more prone to using my phone with my friends as opposed to at school. Like, at school, I'm just going to...
In front of, like, a professor or something where you're supposed to be professional.
Exactly. So I think that... This is how I deal with any addiction. I remove myself from the context that might persuade me to use it. So I just don't bring my phone.
Yeah.
But now I have jobs that require, I love random communication, like communication at times that aren't just like 9 to 5.
Yeah.
So I've recently downloaded an app called Opal.
Mm-hmm.
You know about this?
I've heard of this.
Opal is great. Right now they're having 50% off. This probably weeks later, actually, they're not having a sale.
50% off of what, Jack?
It's $150. But then your phone...
Like, price to only one call...
One time.
One time fee.
You pay them $150 and they make your phone unusable.
Except for what, though?
Okay, so you give it them your outlines. So I want to spend an hour a day on social media, an hour a day on the internet, but I also want to spend from 7 to 9... free of technology, and I want to not use my phone 2 hours before bed. So they will go into your computer, your iPad, your phone, anywhere where it's downloaded, and block websites and apps.
Mm-hmm.
And there's no way to undo it. So by the time that it's hit the focus mode,
yeah,
you can't undo it. Like, you can't bypass it by getting a VPN. You just simply have to be with your thoughts.
Mm-hmm.
And it's quite infuriating. So many times... I'm in the middle of a focus bout and I'm so mad at my phone for not letting me be on YouTube. I've turned it off. I deleted the app.
I
deleted the app.
And it
still blocks it.
Yeah.
I've gone to the point, my internet addiction is so bad. I'd use school computers to watch YouTube when I couldn't on my phone.
Whoa.
It's gotten to that point.
Yeah.
So I physically have to go on a walk. I have to take, I brought my sketchbook just to like kind of show what I do. I have to literally write on a journal. Don't be on your phone.
Yeah.
Don't be on your soul.
Literally anything else.
Anything else. It is that strong for me.
Do you
feel like it's that strong for you? Do you have control over it or do you feel like it takes over?
I do feel like it takes over. Like I'm one of those people when I'll be working on something, especially on my laptop, and I'll get a text or a message from someone and I'll go and I'll answer it really quick. And then I'm just on my phone. Totally. 10 minutes will go by and I'm like, hold on, I was writing an essay. Like, what? How did this happen? Now I'm just scrolling.
I'll give you one worse than that.
Oh, no.
I've been on my phone, seen a deadline clicking, and not cared enough to stop using my phone. Like, I see that I have something due in 30 minutes. I'm just looking at it. And I'm like, it couldn't be more important than this.
Disagree or unbothers.
No, it couldn't. And it's come to a point where I actually take a lot of time and we've written down a list of, I would call them tips, maybe, resources.
Yeah.
Advice.
I would say mine is mostly advice.
But really, I think it's just about starting a conversation about what we can do to be off our phones a little bit.
And I think a lot of it, too, is just to not feel embarrassed about it.
Exactly.
Because a lot of people feel embarrassed about it. And most of the people that we talk to. On campus, they were embarrassed about it. Like, people declined to talk to us because they didn't want to talk about their screen time.
Exactly.
But then everyone we talked to was pretty much in the same range, except for a couple, like, outliers.
But you know what was funny? And this is inherent to this addiction. It doesn't matter if you spent 3 hours or 13 hours, you're embarrassed of it.
Yeah, yeah.
Which is very much in line with other addictions, right? It doesn't matter if you're embarrassed because you did coke twice that week or you can get off fentanyl. Is the idea that you can't control this behavior, right? So in order to control my behavior, I've done a couple of things. I've stayed away from certain mental spaces and I've done physical things in my environment to better correct those. So I would like to start by, instead of, you know, I just want to give some resources. Don't beat yourself up over it and don't think that you have to stop being on your phone. But I would just like to address certain things that help me understand why we're on our phone so much. The number one resource I could find and could recommend anybody is a book called Stolen Focus. I can't remember the author. It'll all be in the description. I will send all of the information. But it pretty much talks about the institutional and systemic forces that actually kind of want us to be addicted to our phones.
Oh, yeah.
And knowing that people want you and prey on you to be on your phone kind of makes you feel less guilty for being on your phone, or it helped me. Because I'm like, oh, it's only me and every other person in the human species that's addicted to their phone. So I didn't guilt trip over it as much anymore. The number
two resources I would provide. This is another book, and it's also 1,200 pages. So I don't know how much of a resource it actually is, but Behave by Robert Sapolsky explains a lot of our brain and why we can't focus.
Telling people that can't focus and get off their phones to read 1,200 pages.
Exactly. That's not going to work. So
no. But read the first book first, and then you'll feel better about your reading chops.
I have a Netflix thing.
Oh, there we go.
Yes.
Start there.
I watch How to Focus on Netflix.
They're 20 minutes for that exact same reason. People can only handle 20 minutes.
Mm-hmm.
So if you can't focus for longer than 20 minutes, go to Netflix, type in How to Focus, watch the episode, and then think about it. Like, don't watch the next episode. They recommend that. So in the episode, it's really funny because they're like, are you even watching right now? They trick you because they know that you're not watching. Because people will not watch for more than 20 minutes.
Just the fourth wall break.
The fourth wall would read is crazy.
Yeah.
So go there, start there. Don't feel like you have to suddenly start meditating 6 hours a day. Because guess what?
You can't do it.
You're going to download Opal and then you're going to become a monk. And you can live in the woods and never think about your phone.
That's not realistic.
Unfortunately, it's not.
You have some kind of word, pretty realistic advice. My advice is to go watch Netflix in 20-minute increments or more.
Yeah.
Every time, instead of spending 20 minutes on TikTok, watch an episode of something that you like.
Yeah, I think a big step for me in trying to get off my phone was just doing that, like watching more like long form content. Like if I'm gonna sit and stare at my phone, if it's a 20-minute YouTube video, it's not great, but it's better than 80 TikToks.
80.
I don't know how many TikToks would fit 20 minutes. But I don't know. This seems like such old person boomer advice, but read a book. Oh my God, read a book. Like, what happened? I sound like such an old person. But everybody used to read all the time because there was nothing else to do. Like, if you had a day off and you have nowhere to be, nothing else to do, like, read a book, get a hobby, go to the gym. Like, there's just so many things that we could be doing instead of staring at our phones for hours and hours and hours on end.
I agree with that. But I have a great counter argument. To me, the idea of just go out and read a book, it sounds very much like the old like the people who say, pull yourself up by your bootstraps.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? So
I get that. But on the other hand, it's like, how are you actually going to break this addiction if you don't try? Like, you're not going to be able to sit down and read the whole book.
No, you're not.
You're going to sit down and you're going to read 10 pages and then you're going to go look at your phone. But then you might come back and read 10 more pages and then look at your phone. And that's better than staring at your phone for 20 minutes.
I agree with that so much.
Yeah. And I ever since I was in like high school, I feel like we talked to a lot of people about this too, that sort of shared the same experience. Like I used to read so much when I was younger and now I just don't. And I was very much in that same boat. And like, about 2-ish years ago when I first tried to delete TikTok, I really started actually reading again. And it was just so like, I don't know, this like childhood like nostalgia that sort of came back for me because I'm also a huge nerd. And so I started reading this very, very nerdy sci-fi series. And now I'm like 6 books in. But it's just about like finding those things. Like if it's nerdy sci-fi books that get you to not stare at your phone for 3 hours, like why not?
Yeah.
Like if that's what gets you off your phone, if that's what gets you entertained, like find a book you like. There's so many. I don't get people that don't like reading because I just don't think that they found the right book yet.
Yeah. I believe that people don't like reading. I very much believe it. I think that it is a very like, it's boring, bro. Reading is boring.
It's not.
Loves it, but it love reading. So, but I need to play devil's advocate because Danny spent such a propaganda. That's weird. But I think that there is probably, it's the,
these libraries,
the big library. No, but the thing about focus, the thing that you mentioned was, is you're going to read 10 pages, you're going to get distracted, and you're going to come back. That's what meditation is, right? You sit with your breath, you catch a thought, and then you tell yourself, come back to your breath.
Yeah, it's like working out, you know, like you're not going to be able to read the whole 350-page book in one go. You're not going to be able to lift 300 pounds your first time working out. But like slowly and slowly, you get better and better. And then you stop thinking about your phone.
Yeah. And like, that's a great thing to move on to. I think now I've recently gotten to 6 months without Instagram.
Damn.
And yes.
So I've permanently deleted my Instagram, like my profile, which was one of those things. I had a certain amount of followers that I thought, oh my God, I'm going to lose my followers.
Yeah, there's like this weird emotional attachment to it.
Exactly. Yeah. And now I don't even know how to say, I'm not even into memes. Like that used to be my personality. Now people have to explain to me what Haktua is. You know what I'm saying? Like, I know nothing.
I wish I didn't know what Haktua was.
So I'm just very, very thankful that I found this information when I did, because I'm seeing people who came into their 30s, got their, they've had their phone now for 15 years.
Yeah.
And now they're mid-30s and they can't stop making TikToks of their babies. And they can't stop making TikToks of all of the food that they eat.
No.
And I simply could not fathom not having a private life.
Mm-hmm.
Not having a hobby that I don't try to monetize.
Yeah.
Not having a space to self-reflect. It just seems like they're robbing us of our attention, because it benefits that people don't self-improve.
Yeah.
Because reading is self-improvement. You're self-reflecting. You're spending time with yourself. So the more time that we can spend on our phone and not be with ourselves, the most the tech companies seem to profit off of it. And that just makes me really mad.
Yeah. No, it is really, really upsetting.
Especially because I can't control it and they get me every time.
Mm-hmm, exactly. They've got it literally down to a science, how to keep people engaged in looking at their phones.
Yeah, totally. And I just want to we have this last little point here, and I want to acknowledge that this is like a serious addiction.
Mm-hmm.
And we're getting more and more studies on it. So if you feel like, if you have exams tomorrow and you can't get off your phone, have an accountability buddy. Tell your friend, tell a family member that you're struggling with this, because that's how addictions evolve.
Yeah.
And seek like some sort of counseling help, etc.
The first step is admitting you have a problem.
It really is, though.
Yeah.
And after you realize that it is not normal to spend 10 hours a day on your phone.
Yeah.
And that we empathize with that. Really get a friend, talk to it with your parents, something, because you're on the track to lose 25 years of your life online. And you're already not eating that healthfully. And you know what I mean? Like, we're doing a lot of things that are really harmful to our bodies and to our minds. So if we continue to not acknowledge this, and if we continue to say, oh, I spent 6 hours, but half of it was for work. It's like, no, it wasn't.
Yeah, no.
We need to acknowledge this problem and that we don't have self-control over this. I don't have self-control over this. I'm trying my hardest. But it seems to be a serious issue in our culture that it's kind of like, ha-ha, lol, phones.
Just nobody questions it.
No. So, like, really talk about it. I feel very vulnerable talking about it today. It's the only thing that's kept me on my phone today.
Honest.
Sorry.
Yeah, the screen time as low as possible.
Exactly. It's a serious problem. I'm looking out, and it's necessary that we talk about it. I challenge the viewers today to put away your phone for 1 hour and your computer for 1 hour, but you can't. It can be because you're doing something else. You have to just not be with your technology for 1 hour. That's a great place to start.
Yeah, I think so.
I know that I'm going to do it today.
Yeah.
But other than that, please talk about it.
Yeah.
Yeah. All right. That was a little bit of a grim note. However, there is hope. We know that we don't live in a binary world. Not everything on social media is bad. Not everything on the internet is bad. So just be mindful of the media that you consume. Don't be super emotional about it. And yeah, enjoy your time on the internet.
Yeah. Enjoy your time on the internet. Don't spend too much time on it, especially with exams coming up.
Seriously.
And yeah, that being said, thank you guys so much for tuning in. I would say follow us on TikTok and Instagram, but that feels a little bit inappropriate right now. So maybe wait till the next episode. I won't feel so bad about it. They're probably down below if you are really fiending to do some doom scrolling, though. Yeah, good luck on exams, everybody. And thank you so much for watching.
See you next time, guys. Thank you. All right.